chance to win $25,000. Before the competition began, a traditional luau gave everyone a chance to get to know each other and decide who would make the best teammate.
Is there a girl here that maybe you know you don't want to be partners with?
That's just wrong.
Kyle said he wouldn't want Summer on his team because she was a threat. And Javier was challenged to dance the hula, but his shyness made the others think twice about choosing him as a partner.
It was a nightmare.
The first game decided who would get to choose teammates. When Javier beat everyone to the Bacana Ball Idol, he won the chance to make the first choice of partners.
Chastity.
Now there are six teams. Javier and Chastity, Kyle and Cherry, Nancy and Drew, Brittany and AJ, Chloe and Jacob, and Summer and Clark. Each one is determined to win it all on Moolah Beach.
Okay, today, one team goes. And really, I'm scared because, like, you know how you get that feeling that it's gonna be you? Oh, I'm going through that.
Ow!
I think a lot more people are intense now because the games are gonna start today.
Come on.
Ready? Well, yesterday, we were all in high spirits. And today, the fact just finally set in that two people are going through, and we don't know who it is.
So, okay, you're going down.
Things are definitely heating up here on Moolah Beach.
You guys aren't teammates.
That was my forehead that
time. I'm sorry.
So last show, we all found out a lot about each other, didn't we?
Yeah.
Javier, had a challenge for you. Wanted you to go across the way and dance. Didn't happen.
I couldn't do it.
I want you to know some of the other players were a little worried about your determination and your willingness to do stuff. But I think you squashed all that when we launched the first Bacana Ball and you grabbed the idol. Yeah. So nice job there, okay? Yeah. Good luck today. And Summer, Drew looked right at you and said, I wouldn't want her as my partner. She's too good looking is basically what he said, right? Maybe you showed them a little thing or two as the only girl to pull that idol off the Bacana Ball, so congratulations. Yeah. Now it's time to get down to business. You got two missions ahead of you, and when we're finished, one team is going to be two idols closer to $25,000, and one team is going to be paddling off into the sunset on their way home. I'm sure you don't want that to happen. Are you guys all psyched up?
Yeah.
Good, let's get started. Our first Makahiki mission is going to be called the Pig Spit. It's a variation on that traditional Hawaiian feast we had last night. Only difference is you guys are going to be the little piggies getting roasted this time. One member from each team is going to get onto the pig spit at the same time, and we're going to turn this thing around faster and faster. Last team on the pig spit is going to win. Just to keep things interesting, the other player is going to be on the sidelines basting anyone they want with those basters right over there. You can all gang up on one player, or you can spread it around. First, you have to choose one member from each one of your teams to be on the pig spit. Green team, who's it going to be? Kyle's gonna go up there. Purple team, who's it gonna be? Orange team, you're going. Red team, okay. Blue team, yellow team. Okay, the people who are basting, head over to the basters. Last team member on the pig spit gets two idols. Are we all ready?
Yeah.
Get set. Go. Thank you. Let me help you down. Come on down this way. Give me your hand, I'll help you up. Jump up here. This guy showed everybody the determination right here. He held on. He was screaming every time it was going around. Green team, you guys are on your way to two idols, one step closer to winning the grand prize.
We just did our first mission. That was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life.
Pigspit was really, really horrible. It may look easy, but it's really hard. The pigspit was actually very hard and actually very painful, but...
I don't care if pain.
I really got soaked a lot. The basers were really out for me because I guess they feel that I'm the strongest.
I'm happy I got in second place, but I'm also disappointed that I was about this close from coming in first.
What can I say? There's gotta be one loser, and I guess I'm it.
I had no idea who fell off and when they did. I figured at the end, whenever they stopped it, everyone was still on. I had no idea. But I won a Makahiki one, so I'm pretty happy with that.
Cal did all the work, he really did. Like, I'm taking credit too, but I feel like awful about it. I have a lot of heart for him right now, I really do.
I was the only girl that chose to do it because my partner, Jacob, my arms are a little bit longer than his, and we had to like wrap our legs and arms around it, so I decided to do it. Jacob said that he had suntan lotion in his eyes, but he was making noises like he was crying, and I felt really bad.
Jacob, are you all right? What happened to
you? Just in his eyes.
Does he really have stuff in his eyes?
I think he's just really upset.
He's like the youngest,
but he's such a cutie. Yeah.
He's just upset because a lot of people were saying like, oh, they're not gonna win because they're smaller or whatever. But I think he's just disappointed.
He's a lot smaller than all the other guys here, and a lot of us felt like, oh, because he's small, he can't handle this. And then he was on top of that. He was the only guy who didn't.
I was kind of disappointed that I thought over it. Maybe I should have went and done it. But I mean, I think Chloe did a really good job.
It was definitely bothering him, you know. But we're going to have a lot more of these, so he's just going to have to get used to it.
Come look you in the eye.
Come walk with me for a second.
I tried to talk to him, and he wouldn't talk to me. So I felt really bad. He's like running from me. He's like afraid of me, I think.
I was like, you know what? Just come talk to me next time. You know, I'm here. That's what we're here for. We can't communicate. What are we gonna do, you know?
How am I supposed to
communicate? Yeah, I understand what you mean.
I just wish he'd feel better. I don't care if we won. I'd just rather he feel better.
You could be wearing $25,000 right now.
The girls are so mean. I am majorly having a problem with Brittany.
Want the scoop on Moolah? Then log on to MoolahBeach.com and check out everything Moolah.
That was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life.
Meet the players, discover the true meaning of the 13 idols of the island, and check out behind-the-scenes action that we could never show you on TV.
I did a lot of things that, you know, I knew I was going to regret.
Plus, find out how you can chat live with the last team that got booted off the beach. At MoolahBeach.com, if the sun doesn't burn you, someone else will.
Congratulations on winning the first Makahiki mission. Nice job, don't you think? Now it's time to collect your reward. Two of the 13 Moolah Beach idols. Koho in Hawaiian, you know what it means? Choice. And you know what that means. The right Koho here may be worth $25,000. So, which idols do you want to choose? You get two. Sherry, you can go first.
I choose the warrior.
Warrior Koa. Go ahead and grab the necklace.
I chose this one basically because I thought it was more likely to have the cash prize in it. Kind of jumping ahead, but yeah, that was the first thing that was on my mind when I came to choosing.
You could be wearing $25,000 right now. You're up. Which one do you want?
Strength.
Strength. That in Hawaiian is Ikaika. Go ahead and grab that.
Well, I originally chose the god of the shark, but I don't know. It was just like a gut feeling. I just wanted to go for strength.
You guys are two idols closer to the money, but you see those other 10 people right there? Guess what? They're gonna try and stop you. Yeah! In the meantime, I got a special bonus, one of four secret clues, which will help you decide which one does not have the grand prize, okay? Now, that clue can be invaluable if you guys are lucky enough to come up and get two more idols in the future. You don't wanna tell anyone what's in there, okay? All right, go ahead, go off there and read it. Maybe next time, you guys will get up here, huh?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sorry. All right. My bed is not for sleeping, nor do I hold the prize.
That is the most confusing clue I've ever seen before in my life.
I think it's fire bed.
Maybe. Or a sun bed. Like a tanning bed? I don't know.
I even went over there and looked at all the gods, and it made no sense. The closest I can come to is the god of fire. Fire bed? I don't know.
So make sure we point at everything just to throw them off, because they're probably going to be watching us.
Yeah.
Okay. I got this giant one, but...
That's fish. That's the hula.
Let's point at everything on fire.
Yeah. If by some chance we were to be kicked off the island, I haven't really put into consideration whom I would will the idols to. I think I do have a good chance of getting the idols, or hopefully.
Those weren't the idols that I would have picked, though, so it doesn't really matter to me. I want the shark one, because I'm really scared of the shark. I don't know, but I think maybe it's in there.
Me and Brittany are trying to keep our relationship with the players nice and easy. That way, if we do stay on and they get eliminated, we get their idols.
I guess we'll just have to see.
Well, a lot of people are gonna try to make better friends with Kyle and Sherry just to try to get the idols. I'm not gonna do that.
Well, I really don't think they're gonna give the idols to us. Sherry and I, we talk, but it doesn't seem like we're getting along as well as I am with some of the other girls. I've considered who I'd want to win and who's most likely going to win. I think Kyle and I are gonna really have a good talk tonight. It's been difficult for me, I guess, because the reason that none of the girls here, well, I can't say none of them, but most of them here are having a problem with me. The guys had mentioned to me that, like, the girls were, like, all talking bad about me and everything about how I was always talking about how
I don't care if we talk to the guys.
I am majorly having a problem with Brittany. Like, she'll sit there and get in the middle of everybody's conversation just because she wants guys' attention, and it's really making me mad. And this has got to stop right now, or something's gonna go down.
The only reason that I talk to the guys a lot is because at my school, the girls there are so mean, and like all they do is as soon as you tell them something, they turn it around and then they go tell everyone else. I'm really only getting along with Nancy in our group just because all the other girls make it seems like they don't really want to talk to me or whatever. I'm not really sure why, but I think it's because I seem to talk to the guys a lot more.
Are you guys sunbathing?
We're sun drying.
She thinks it's because she hangs around all the guys, and it's not. She's the drama queen out of all of us.
Why?
And sometimes it just gets on my nerves.
So has this become now girl talk and boy talk?
You don't need to distinguish it all the time. It can just be talk.
Like, remember how the other day you came in and you were like, oh, can I join girl talk now? Next time that happens, like you're talking to the guys and you want to come talk to the girls, don't say anything. Just come in, you know?
One of the boys told her that we said that she hung up boys too much.
You know, that's not the problem. It's the problem when she gets mad that she's not getting attention.
Right.
She's really nice to the girls, but, I mean,
she's
never...
She's
I can't trust her.
Oh,
like at all.
Of course not.
No.
It's hard for me to talk to the girls, and I have a feeling that me not being close to any of the girls is going to affect how our team does.
I wouldn't want to make enemies, but it's all for the best.
The mood has just changed.
They're all planning against us.
Can we talk for a second?
Everyone's going to want us off.
Hey.
Hey,
JD.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
Hi.
Why don't you guys come on over, gather around. I know for a little while we've been talking about the Great Kahuna and the fact that we were going to eventually have to go there. Today's the day.
two of you at sunset are going to be on your way home. I know that doesn't sound too good, does it?
No.
No.
So start thinking about that today. Now, the real reason that I'm here and I'm kind of calling this meeting is we got a package sent overnight, urgent, for one of you. Anybody have any idea who it's for?
Me?
Summer? Summer?
It's for Summer.
Her makeup.
That's what it is?
Is it my makeup?
It's your makeup?
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you what, Summer. I'm going to make you a little proposition. If you'll let us keep your makeup for your entire stay on Moolah Beach, we'll give you guys some information about the Kahuna mission. All of you.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
No makeup for your entire stay?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll hold on to this.
I know Summer is a makeup person, so I saw her give up the makeup. I was like, yeah, Summer.
She not only thought about herself, but she thought about it for all of us. I honestly didn't think it was that big of a deal because she had makeup on this morning because we all let her use ours.
Thank you, Summer.
That means I'm going to give you guys some information about the Kahuna mission that could help you in your chances of staying on Moolah Beach. But first, I got a couple questions for some people. Clark.
Oh.
Purple team.
Yeah.
Feeling good?
I sure am.
If in the Kahuna mission you have to make some enemies, would that be okay?
I wouldn't want to make enemies, but it's all for the best.
What do you mean for the best?
I just do whatever I had to do so they know it's only just for the game.
So you're here to win the money?
Exactly.
All right, good luck.
Thanks.
AJ, yellow team. And the pig spit. Seems like you were the only one getting basted.
I know!
Why is that?
I haven't quite figured that one out yet.
Now, do you think that maybe that means you're going to be targeted in this upcoming Kahuna mission?
More than likely, yes.
And where's Kyle and Sherry?
Right here.
Oh, hey, how you doing? Hello. Hiding there behind me, huh? You guys have idols. I see one around your neck and one around your neck. These can be very valuable. You think the more idols you get, the more people are going to be nice to you?
As the competition gets stiffer, yeah.
Chloe?
Yeah.
You know, I was thinking a little while ago, and I thought, you know, watching all you guys and all the teams that, you know, trust, communication, honesty, pretty much makes a powerful team.
Right.
You think you and Jake have communicated well?
In the beginning we didn't so well, but we worked it out and we are now.
So you think you're a good, solid team?
Yeah.
Jacob, how you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty good about it. I mean, we've worked a lot of things out and I think we can go to like big things and do big things, and I think we're gonna be really good. I think we're a solid team, yeah.
That's the spirit, good job. All right, so I guess you guys are ready for a little information now, huh?
Yeah.
Now that I got all this makeup, I have to hold up my end of the bargain, don't I? All right, here's the information. The Kahuna mission is today. It's this afternoon, and the game is called Rock the Boat. And just like the title, you don't want to rock the boat too hard. We're going to be giving you guys an opportunity to hinder one team's performance drastically. You can all gang up on one team that you'd like off this island. You can also protect the team. You can make sure that one team doesn't lose.
The winning team gets 10 team colored offerings for the Great Kahuna.
The losing team gets only one. If you come in first place, you almost guarantee yourself a chance of staying here. If you come in last place, you're pretty much guaranteeing yourself a spot to be swimming off the island. Okay? So give it some thought today. I'll see you guys this afternoon. Enjoy your breakfast.
See you later.
Good morning. Summer, thanks for the makeup.
Better, Jenny.
That does not sound good.
Okay, my day has just been like...
I know.
Shot again.
I know.
Well, let's see who everyone's ganging up on.
Yeah, I'm gonna go
if everyone's ganging up on someone, don't gang up on them.
Like, I'm talking about people like... Oh my God, who are we gonna get?
Yeah.
And I'm just like, I don't wanna do this.
Look at this, look at this. They're all plotting against us.
Wait, we're talking over here.
That's like
AJ,
though. AJ's cool. Yeah.
But not Jacob.
You
know, not Jacob, you guys.
I can't go against you guys, I'm sorry.
I'll do anything that it takes.
But if everybody protects everybody, we're not gonna get anywhere.
This is gonna be really hard.
What JD said has turned people against each other all of a sudden, just like that. And that's what's scary.
All of a sudden, everybody thinks that we're ganging up on people, and that's exactly what, you know, the last thing that we want to do.
I don't know. The mood has just changed because everybody seems so sad.
I think everybody's feeling it. Aren't you guys feeling it?
Everybody's feeling like people are going against everybody.
We don't want to feel like backstabbers or anything, but we knew that we all wanted to come here to win, so it's going to be really hard for us.
Well, I think the smartest thing to do for our own sake is to team up.
Just do that. Yeah, we'll do that.
Kyle wanted to side up at first with AJ and Brittany.
Take each other. Yeah, protect each other.
But Brittany was not going for it, not at all.
Why are we agreeing when we haven't even talked? Can we talk for a second?
Yeah, hold on.
I'm really not trusting Brittany right now. I don't think anyone is, by the way things are looking right now.
Brittany is so totally disagreeing, because I talked to AJ about, you know, us.
Yeah, I'm already seeing it.
And Brittany just said, can we talk real quick? You know, that's exactly what she did. And she thinks that, you know, I'm full of it.
Me and Brittany just aren't getting along. She always talks about me when I leave, and I don't trust her at all, so I'm not about to make a pact with her.
All those people are, I'm sure, right now making something towards us, and now there's three teams against us and one for us. Wait, four teams.
I am now in the worst mood I've ever been here. I mean, I was having such a great time, and now I'm all stressed out about this. I have no idea what to do.
If we don't get yellow off this first time, because we've got everybody going against yellow, if we don't get them off, are we ever going to get them off?
I know the yellow is going to get teamed up against, and I feel sorry for both AJ and Brittany.
This is $25,000, guys.
Whichever team wins is going to have the best chance of staying on Moolah Beach.
I don't know what they just decided to switch from yellow. I think that was one of the most disgusting things I've ever done in my life.
The Kahuna mission is about to happen. And I think yellow is going to be sought after first. Then comes purple. I haven't heard too much about red. And definitely not green. Nobody's going after green, I don't think. But we'll see. The games, we'll see. People lie, people don't tell the truth. You never can trust people. So we'll find out soon enough.
This is the Kahuna mission, and it's called Rock the Boat. Whichever team wins is gonna have the best chance of staying on Moolah Beach at sundown. Here's how it's done. In front of you over here are tons of coconuts and bags. Take a feel, they're heavy, okay? They're heavy for a reason, because when you begin, you're gonna have 30 seconds to load any cart you want. You can spread them out amongst all the teams, or you can pile them into just one. It's your choice. When you hear the conch shell sound, each team can run to their cart and drag it down to the shoreline. You're then gonna load your boat with the cargo that all these other teams saddled you with. Then you're gonna row out around the bamboo pole and come back to shore. First team to plant their flag right over there gets 10 team offerings to offer the Great Kahuna. Second team gets 5. Third team gets 4, 3, 2, and the last place team is only getting 1. Are you guys ready to go?
Yeah.
All right, everybody hop into position. When you hear the sound, you can start loading.
Thank you.
my growl.
A lot of emotion in playing this game I don't think anybody expected to have.
Yeah, I'm not proud of this.
And I think everybody did a great job. I saw a lot of hustle out there and a lot of character. I'm proud of you guys. Still, we have an order. We've got purple team who came in first, the green team came in second, yellow team you're third, red team is fourth, orange team is fifth, and blue, you're in sixth place. Nothing's been decided yet. At sundown, we're gonna go to the Great Kahuna. Looks like by the way the sun is now, you guys have a couple hours to hang out. The Great Kahuna will render his decision. No decision has been made yet. So I'll see you guys tonight in the jungle to meet the Great Kahuna. All right? Hang in there, guys. I'll see you later.
Well, I think everyone as a group first decided that it was the yellow group for us to target. But last minute, Kyle was the one who came up with the idea of getting the blue team.
We decided to gang up on the blue team because at first, you know, we all thought, what team would we field the least sad about leaving? The fact that Javier didn't talk much and we didn't really get to know him very well because he wasn't very social. And the fact that Chastity, no one was actually very, very close to her.
I tried so hard.
It was either them or the yellow team, and we decided that AJ was too much of a positive influence on everybody that it wasn't worth it.
I kind of did feel that the other teams were ganging up on us. But I don't think they did it on purpose.
How many coconuts did you have?
We had, I think, 6 or 8, 6 to 8.
God, we had like 30.
Some people made a pact with Blue that they were gonna be allies, and they totally broke it.
I said that they could trust me. That was the worst thing in the world. Totally betrayed them.
I feel like this is wrong.
Yeah, me too.
Nobody actually thought about what they were doing before and what they were doing while they were doing it. It just seems like nobody had feelings until the very end, and they looked and saw what we all had really done.
It was really hard to watch them lose, I guess, just because the fact that I knew that we had done that. We had put those coconuts in there.
She kept on, like, crying and all that kind of stuff, when actually, I don't think she was that sad. I felt like she was acting most of it, and a lot of people were just kind of looking at each other like, oh my gosh, what did she do?
I just think that was one of the most disgusting things I've ever done in my life. I promised myself I'll never do it again.
I'm so sorry. I'll be happy if I go home and just let you guys stay.
I mean, I feel bad because I said I was going to team up on yellow. But that was because certain, like, out of everybody, only certain people.
You knew too?
About the blue? No, I didn't know about the blue. I just knew about teaming up on yellow.
I trust Kyle a lot. The fact is that he just switched on the blue team.
It was me that said the blue team. It was me that said it.
It bugged me the most that you were the one who said it, because you said that you put your trust in me.
I really regret doing that, honestly. I mean, it will happen again, but it's just, it's so tough.
And I felt really betrayed.
I think the guys, like, decided it together, but we did have something to do with it. We could have sat there and said, no, I'm not gonna do that to them.
I feel bad because we went along with it. We didn't stop them. And I feel that standing and watching is just as much of the crime as doing it.
We did what we shouldn't have done and what we all agreed that we shouldn't do. But then again, we're all terrified of losing, and we're all selfish. We're very selfish.
I accept your apology.
Luck is on your side. Understand?
Yeah.
Handled it so well. I talked to her about it and she's like, okay, I forgive you. I just wanted you
and everybody else to come up and talk to me about it.
I think everyone's, like, learned their lesson. We talked about it, and everyone thought if we could do it over, we would equal everything out by putting 2 coconuts in each basket.
From now on, I'm telling everyone that it's all for themselves. There is no plans. There are absolutely no plans.
Actually, something good did come out of this. We actually saw everybody's true feeling. Everybody feels bad for everybody.
I think it's gonna be so sad.
This is obviously a big moment. Next team staying on Moolah Beach.
The worst moment's about to come up where
we're about to go see the Great Kahuna, and I'm not looking forward to it.
Looking forward to see who leaves, and if it's me, I seriously wouldn't mind because then we don't have to go through the pain again.
That's right.
It just hasn't hit me yet because nothing's happened yet. No one's kicked off yet, so nothing's for certain.
I think it's gonna be so sad. I don't know who's going to be gone, but I'm going to be as emotional as I was at the game. And I think we all are.
I am gonna be really sad no matter who it is because there's only one person that I wouldn't mind seeing go, and that's Brittany. Anybody else? I'm gonna be like totally devastated over because it's gonna change like everything.
Everybody has their offering for the Great Kahuna. This is obviously a big moment. We've been talking about this for days, and finally it's come. A lot of emotion down there during the Kahuna mission, wasn't there?
Yeah.
But it looked like some of you, maybe you chose the game over friendship, and maybe that's what was upsetting you. Clark, how did you feel?
I honestly think that what we did was very childish and was a childish way to get a team off. And the fact that I've one out of doing that makes me feel even worse.
Now remember, you could have loaded all the boats equally. You could have put one in every single one of them. We left that up to you, but you didn't. Why?
I think that we were afraid of the competition. Seriously.
Kyle, if you could play the mission over again, would you play it the same way?
No.
How would it change?
The fact that, I don't know, it was just the way it came about just was really unfair because a lot of people had made a pact with the blue team in the first place, and so the blue team was totally unaware of anything like that.
What kind of pact did they make with the blue team?
From what I heard, a handshake and a promise.
And what was that promise?
That we're allies. And a lot of people broke that, so that's the sad part about it. So
there were things going on behind other people's back. Chloe, how'd that make you feel?
I felt like maybe something else was going behind my back.
So in a way, you guys are trying to figure out who are your friends and who aren't. Chastity.
Yeah.
Were you part of making an ally?
Yes, I was.
And how did it feel when the time was up and you looked in your cart? It was full.
I felt really betrayed.
Keep your head up. You never know what can happen here. And now it is time for the Great Kahuna to decide who will stay and who will go. Here's how this is gonna work. As I can see with you, you guys brought an offering containing the number of team-colored idols you won during that Kahuna mission. One at a time, you'll approach me at the Great Kahuna and make that offering. And don't forget, the larger your offering, the greater chances of you staying. Purple team, you have 10, so you should be looking pretty good. Now, when the Great Kahuna comes alive, you're gonna see his eyes start spinning. All your idols will be in his eyes, and then one will fall into his mouth. That lucky team gets to stay on Moolah Beach. It'll happen 4 more times until one final team remains. That team, unfortunately, will be exiled from the beach, and the boat is already waiting. Is everybody ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Purple team, with 10 idols, you can make your offering. Step up, Shari, and make your offering. You came in second place, you have 5. Good luck. Third place. Come on up, Brittany. You guys have 4. Good luck. Nancy, for the red team, you have 3 offerings. Good luck. Jake, come on up here. 2 offerings. Good luck. Last team to come up here, Javier. You've got 1, and it's blue. I'm putting it in right now. Okay, that's it. They're all in there. It's now time for the Great Kahuna to make his first decision. Looks like the green team stays on Moolah Beach. Now, the interesting thing is, the green team, you came in second place. You only had half as many offerings as the purple team. Yet you guys are staying. This one's good luck. Hold on to it. It is now time for the Great Kahuna to make his decision again. Second team, the red team.
Oh.
The red team only had 3. They have 10.
Oh.
The Great Kahuna's been good to you. You guys getting a little nervous?
Yeah.
I am too. Kahuna, render your next decision. Next team staying on Moolah Beach is the purple team. Purple team, you guys get to stay. Good job. It pays to come in first. We now have the first 3 teams. The only colors that have not come up are the blue team, the orange team, and the yellow team. Now time for the Great Kahuna to render another decision. The next team staying on Moolah Beach, yellow. Yellow team stays, good job. That one's yours. Okay, we only have 1 left. The next one that comes out is the team that gets to stay. Final decision, and the team that gets to stay on Moolah Beach.
Want the scoop on Moolah? Then log on to moolahbeach.com and check out everything Moolah.
That was one of the hardest things that I've ever done in my life.
Meet the players, discover the true meaning of the 13 idols of the island, and check out behind-the-scenes action that we could never show you on TV.
I did a lot of things that, you know, I knew I was going to regret.
Plus, find out how you can chat live with the last team that got booted off the beach. At moolahbeach.com, if the sun doesn't burn you, someone else will.
There are 2 teams left, the orange team and the blue team. I'd like you guys to slide down and have you guys come on in here. Orange team, come on in here. Blue team, slide over here a little more. The next one that comes out is the team that gets to stay. So remember, if your color does not come out of the Great Kahuna's mouth, you're leaving the beach. It is now time for the final decision. The final decision, and the team that gets to stay on Moolah Beach, the orange team. Orange team, you guys get to stay. Blue team, you played a great game. We appreciate you guys being here, and we care a lot about you, okay? Thanks, the boat is waiting for you guys down there. Go ahead and walk right down the bridge.
Thank you.
experience at Moolah Beach was interesting and was something new. I got to meet really cool people. I'm really glad I came here.
Like sad, not upset really, but sad, because I wanted to stay on Moolah Beach. I'm still gonna be a nice person regardless. I know how to pick my friends. I know how to choose my friends, like, accordingly.
I think me and Jesse aren't gonna stay friends, or we're gonna keep in touch. And since we live in the same place, I think we are gonna meet each other again. That makes me feel a little bit better. I get somebody to share all my moments that I spent at Moolah Beach.
I do wish the rest of the teams good luck, and I do believe they all have the potential to win. I just really wish I could stay.
Contestant airfare provided by Pleasant Hawaiian Holidays.
On the next Moolah Beach.
On your mark, get set, go!
The game is on.
We're not playing patty cake.
And packs are being made.
If he's not with us, then he's our main target.
Plus,
romance on Moolah Beach.
I have a crush.
Is she really worth $25,000?
Moolah Beach, next weekend at 12, 11 Central on Fox Family.